What worries me is what's going to happen in this country. Obama raised such exaggerated expectations, such great hopes in people, precisely because he was an unknown. I recall reading that a Peruvian peasant was asked why he voted for a particular candidate for presidency. He said, because I know nothing about him. And I'm afraid that's what happened in this country. People voted for Obama because they knew nothing about what he really was going to carry out. And it's a very dangerous situation when you raise exaggerated high hopes and then you dash them down. We know what happened in France after 1968. De Gaulle came back to power with a vengeance. The Labour Party disappointed people in England in the 60s, and the Thatcher regime came in. Yeah. Carter disappointed people in this country, and we got Reagan. What's going to happen, as seems to be starting right now, when this exaggerated hopes are dashed down? Do we have real dangers here, and how can we fight that?
Yeah, you're quite right. And in fact, his Obama and his campaign managers made sure you would know nothing about him, or very little about him. I mean, if you look back at the campaign, the slogans were hope and change. What hope for what? You know, what change? Well, at that point, it kind of evaporates. Why hope and change? Well, you know, campaign managers are intelligent enough to read polls, and they knew that 80% of the population thought the country's going in the wrong direction. Okay, hope and change. In fact, those were McCain's slogans too, except he didn't do it as well. Obama made it primarily because the financial institutions, who are, have enormous power in the country, mainly thanks to Reagan and Clinton, they preferred him to McCain. So they poured money into the Obama campaign way beyond McCain, and that's the core of the funding, and yes, he managed to make it, you know, over to win the election. And it shouldn't come to as a surprise to anyone who knows anything about American political history that they're being paid off. Just take a look at the front pages every day. The big problem for the big banks now is that the profits and the bonuses are so high that they're getting a bad press. You know, so they have to figure out some way to conceal it by, say, taking them in stocks instead of money. So you're kind of borrowing money from the public instead of stealing it. You know, so sure, they're getting paid off for having put Obama in office. But the other programs are, well, you know what's happening to them. He's probably a nice man, I don't know. But there shouldn't, just as you said, there should be no surprise. They were very careful to keep it quiet. And that's characteristic of U.S. elections. The U.S. elections are a facade. I mean, they are run by the public relations industry, who market candidates the same way they market toothpaste and lifestyle drugs. I mean, when you see an ad on television, you know you're not supposed to believe it. You know, it's not an attempt to inform you the way it would be in a market system. It's a way to create uninformed consumers who will make irrational choices, exactly the opposite of what you're taught in an economics class about markets. But business spends huge amounts of money to undermine markets by constructing uninformed consumers who are supposed to make irrational choices. And the same institutions, PR institutions, run the campaigns. And they market candidates the same way. They want an uninformed electorate that will make irrational choices. And in fact, as maybe you know, Obama won an award from the advertising industry for the best marketing campaign of 2008. He beat out Apple Computer. And if you read the business press, executives were euphoric. They said, you know, it's the best we've done since Reagan, when we sort of were able to market him. Now we have an even better achievement. It's going to change the atmosphere in corporate boardrooms, you know, new ways of behaving and portraying ourselves and so on. Yeah, that's the case. And one technique is, if you really want to create an uninformed electorate, you have to keep issues off the agenda. And there's a second reason for that. On issues, both of the political parties are commonly well to the right of the population. So it's important to keep issues off the table, make sure people don't know what they are. So yeah, you're quite right. And what will the result likely be? And my suspicion is an erosion of the base for the Obama campaign, because people will be disillusioned. They shouldn't be, but they will be, and it's understandable. And a very significant backlash. There's a major group of, huge group of people in the country who feel they have serious grievances. The grievances come back, go back to the 1970s. The shift of the economy from production to finance, which is a huge shift that took place primarily under Reagan and then Clinton, and of course Bush even more extreme. And that's left a lot of people out in the cold. The majority of the population have seen their wages and incomes stagnate for 30 years. Their benefits decline, you know, services decline, infrastructure collapse, and so on. And they're not happy about it. And they want to know, why is this happening to me? If you listen to talk radio, you get a good sense of it, which I do. When I drive, I listen. The standard person is saying something like, I've done everything right. I'm a hardworking, decent, white Christian. I've done everything right. Why is this happening to me? Well, who's going to give him an answer? They're not going to get an answer from the Republican Party saying, yeah, that's the policies we designed to shaft you and enrich a couple of rich people. And they're not going to get an answer from the Democratic Party saying, well, that's pretty much our policy too, except maybe not as extreme. So they get an answer from Rush Limbaugh and Glenn Beck, who tell them, well, I got an answer. It's the rich liberals who own the banks and run the government and own the media and don't care about you people, the flyover people. They only care about the rich folk and the on the two coasts. They want to give everything away to illegal immigrants and, you know, the unworthy poor and so on. So, yeah, that's your problem. Well, you know, if that's the only answer you're going to get, people are likely to believe it. And we've had experiences like this. It's unfortunately reminiscent of late Weimar Germany, where there were also were people with grievances. And they were getting an answer, crazy answer, horrible answer, but happened to take over with consequences we know about. I'm not saying that's going to happen here, but the similarities are not insignificant.